Welcome to That's a Wrap, the channel where I review TV shows and movies. I am your host, Ricky, and today we're back at it with WandaVision Episode 4. And what an episode it was. But before I continue, like and subscribe to the channel. And spoiler warning for anyone that hasn't seen episode 4. I'm going to try to keep it as spoiler free as I can, because I know a lot of people haven't even seen how they haven't seen episodes of 4 and 5 is beyond me. But people are busy, and I know people are getting disappointed as far as the amount of spoilers that are around this show. I mean, leaks are, this thing has more leaks than something that sinks really fast. But you know, it's not sinking. The way the internet is grabbing these leaks and running, I think it's somewhat a little bit by design. They know that we're starving for material, and not like content creators. I'm just saying people, you know, given the pandemic and what's going on, they know we're gonna just take it and run with it and develop our own content, you know, deviating from theirs or coming away from what they're putting out. So I think some of the leaks that are happening are probably a little bit self-inflicted. They wouldn't admit to it, but I think they're stirring the pot a little bit for sure. You know, maybe not all of it, but for sure, I think some of it is by design. But again, wow, what an episode. This episode, I think, it still is now, even with episode 5 and having seen episode 5, episode 4 is still my favorite episode. That opening scene was, I thought it's just me. You know, everybody has their own likes and dislikes. But that scene where Thanos snaps them away was amazing. The part where, you know, Captain America and, you know, towards the end of Endgame, awesome. The Tony Stark one in at the end when he snaps, memorable. But honestly, I think number one is that opening scene. That reaction, not just from, you know, Rambo's part of it, because, you know, it was focusing on her, the aftermath, that whole first scene with the chaos happening and showing us the realism of what would happen, you know, post snap or when Hulk snapped. And I thought the whole thing was captivating. I leaped up when I saw it, like, oh my god, we're in the snap. That's exactly it. The first thing that came out of my mouth was like, oh, we're in the snap. This is the snap after Banner did his. And I probably jumped a couple of feet in the air when I realized that. So I knew it was a very special episode. But that scene has to go down, for me anyways, as number one that I've seen from the whole Infinity Saga up to now. And I get it. A lot of stuff was postponed, so maybe something would have blown my mind more away. But that scene was kind of amazing. And so anyway, so this episode, again, like everyone expects now, I think. And I think for me, it's probably time for me to stop seeming so amazed at the set design, the fact that it's well written. Another episode that follows through very strong. Now, I was a little bit, after watching it so many times, you kind of start noticing a little bit more. And that first scene where Monica is talking to her mom, to the doctor, about her mom's disappearing, I was a little bit like, okay, it wasn't the strongest performance between two of the a main star and an extra given in a show. It wasn't one of the strongest performance right after that amazing scene, right? Like you're just captivated by what you see, and then this lull happens of exposition. Of maybe later on they'll fill those in, but for me, I wasn't super invested. As far as like, I get it, it was super sad, her mom. And they're kind of filling it in with what's going on with the snap. And trust me, I get it. It's a very impactful. But and it's, I'm not saying like by a lot. I didn't say like, oh, it was just horrible and unwatchable. It was after a lot of viewings. Definitely not the first time I saw it, but after, again, a lot of viewings of it, I noticed that. And just at that moment, I felt the same way. It's kind of like the same thing where if I go on Game of Thrones, you don't watch the last episode just because it pisses you off. Or like How I Met Your Mother, you don't watch that last episode because it just, you know, irks you the wrong way. It's kind of like how I viewed it. But I right after that scene, it just picks off. It was basically seeing it from a sword's point of view, or from not Wanda's point of view, which up to the release of this episode, it was what we were seeing, right? And just a little bit of glimpses into the people on the outside, which caused a little bit of the confusion. But I think it's one of the brilliant things that the show did right in the way they're presenting them to us. And it was fascinating to see. I think obviously, if you threw like a montage song over the point where we see the Darcy from Thor, the Dark, or Thor, but just Thor, I was gonna say Thor the Dark World, which she was in that movie too, but she was in that from that scene all the way up to where she develops the TV, or not develops the TV, but figures out, and they get, and she gets it working when the director of S.H.I.E.L.D. or the acting director of S.H.I.E.L.D. is talking. You could have put a montage song over that thing and it would have done the same thing. It happens so quick. Like, she gets there and, you know, where she developed this. I mean, I know she was smart, but we don't get that from, you know, Thor, the Dark World, that she was going to become this doctor. But hey, you know, awesome for her. But it just happened so quick. Almost the same way with, you know, Tony Stark, how he develops time travel. It's like, yeah, you know, one afternoon I was just kicking this and boom, there it is. Time travel. Enjoy. You know, lovely. But yeah, it happened so fast, but I still enjoyed it. I enjoyed seeing how they were finding out the townspeople, how they were going through all the evidence and figuring stuff out. The funny moments that Darcy and Detective Wu, I think is his name, that we're having I like them as a comedy duo. As far, they got me a couple of chuckles out of me. But yeah, I think it was definitely a filler to now. Hopefully more people don't feel so lost now and kind of have more to run with it. The acting director of S.H.I.E.L.D. though, I mean, maybe it was me, but at first I was like, okay, he's gonna be an ally, and obviously you're starting to see a turn in him, whether it be some kind of whatever motive he has, but he's starting to show his colors. Some of the stuff was shoddy, repetitive. But I got it as far as like why they were doing it, like exposition 101 through the whole thing. I was like, oh, this is why we found this and this and this, and this is what led us to this and this and this and this. And again, great episode, loved it as far as like the reveals I mean, when I saw Darcy coming in, I'm like, oh, dope. You know, this is another person, you know, another character I know now in this show. And I hope they continue doing this. But enjoyed it. Complete enjoyment from this TV series. Complete enjoyment from episode 4. I don't know if it's anywhere in my top 5. But it's definitely now one of the creepiest things I ever seen. But it's I want to put it up there in just the reveal. Like, it was one of the more, maybe I should say, visually stunning revelations. But when we saw Vision the way we saw him at the end of Endgame, when I saw the for the first time, I was speechless. I was like, oh, what? And I didn't get scared as far as that, but then my mind did go into the humor part of it, like, oh, you know, is it like a, you know, is he dead and Wanda's like puppet him around like Weekend at Bernie's kind of a thing. But that image, when Wanda looks up and sees Vision in that state, at first I thought that it was, you know, like, yeah, it was his dead corpse. But then again, watching it over again, you notice that he blinks. at when he starts talking to her, when he looks back after the first time we see him and then we see him again, he physically blinks and is talking to him. And I was like, oh, wait, because we know that the Mind Stone is done. It's gone. You know, the last time we saw it, Captain America took it back. So that's the last time we saw the Mind Stone. There's a debate whether, you know, she can create the Mind Stone from her powers. I don't know if it's, if there's a source material where that's from, or some offshoot where that happens. Maybe I could definitely not be aware. But yeah, it's just so many questions that it raised after this episode. But that image of a Vision, the way Thanos left him, was indenting. Is that a word? Like when something indents your mind, I guess. So I'll definitely have that one image in my mind, and maybe I should rank it up higher in as far as like the some of the imagery that Marvel has provided. But again, this episode hasn't missed a beat. I'm gonna continue the streak. 5 out of 5. Completely enjoying this series, and look forward to the rest and see where it leads and what new revelations we're going to have. I hope you guys are enjoying it also along with myself. And let me know what you think of the episode and of this series. Am I just going, you know, too fanboy and I'm not being too critical? I don't think so. I think when you take a unbiased look at the acting, the set, and everything that's going on, and the presentation, I think it's probably one of the more well-rounded shows that is out there right now. And not only right now, I think in current time. So I think we need to appreciate what they're trying to do in an artistic level. And we can only do that by stepping back. So I hope you enjoyed the review. I know it was like a breakdown, so I'm going to probably say it was like a review breakdown with spoilers, because I would hate to ruin it for people. But with that said, that's a wrap.